This morning I'm going to have a go at this beautiful rural, rather run-down old cottage in Ireland. Lots of green and sheep and mist on the hillside. You notice today I've gridded it to see if I can get an even more accurate picture of the shapes and the colours and the tones. So it's a little different for me to grid this, but I thought I'd give this a try and see if it will improve my interpretation. So I've got to try and not have a mass of different of similar greens. I've got to try and vary those greens. We've got some sort of yellowy ones here, acid, almost spring green. And then here we've got the darker, almost yellowy, browny greens. And I must try and catch the rocks here, the old tumble down walls, and the mist. Try and create that mist on the hillside. So let's have a go and see where we can go with it. So I've got two wet our paper, get a nice wet even down through the tree because the mist is coming right down to the bottom here and falling behind, so I've got to get some sort of misty grey colour in there. So I will be able to, I think, that are in my palette here to give me some suggestion of this mist sort of. I think I could put a little bit of blue into it though. Comes down very, very grey, real misty. Wet day in Ireland, which apparently they get plenty of, so I'm told. Yes, I think that's better. Put a little bit of cerulean in there to give me a little bit of a hint of blue coming down here. So it's quite matte. So I should just let it grey out and leave it, I think. Let's make sure it comes down right over there. Right, and also just a little up from just behind here, we've got a little bit of the hillside still visible. So I've got to put a hint of bluey green in there just to see if I can suggest it. Is now the time to do it? Perhaps. Well, it's, I think it needs to be a bit greener. Yes, let it just seep down, diffuse down in the wet of my wash, my first wash. Right, nothing more than that. So I want it just, oh, I could have a little behind the hill there, behind that corner of the house. It's old, ruined cottage. Right. Let me think. Our sheep are walking up this lane. Going to try and get touches of those greens in and come in with my different greens to add some contrast. Think the greens are the most difficult colours to try and cope with. So many of them. Top of it. This white piece here is a bit of metalled road, so I'll try and get some of that. I think it green comes in more there and turns down this lane. I think while it's damp, I will try and get some different sorts of greens. Certainly darker ones, a few dark ones needed, but some quite, well, there's some sticking out of this old house, this old cottage. It's just rack and ruin. In some different greens and tones, some quite browny flecks, parts of the vegetation. Got some trees I'm going to put in there, but this house has got a massive ivy just invading the house, totally destroying it. Amazing how nature will reclaim these buildings, so cared for generations, and then it doesn't take much for them to fall into ruin. Little flecks. Try and introduce different greens as I go. Some yellowy ones in parts. I've got to try and put in these walls. Was so beautifully organized at some point in its heyday. Lots of pathways and walls, but they're all gone now. Some of the basic tones in. Try and get some dry brush strokes. It's dark, quite a bit darker under there. Got some one or two. And in the distance we can see some of our hillside. Got to put our sheep walking along here. Some point. I think some reddy, a little bit of red with our greens will give me a different feel on a smaller brush. I think we need yes, perhaps. Smaller and give me wonder if I can get something with our fan brush. That's not the greatest fan brush, I don't think. Something like this. It's an oil painting. Grey, bluey grey, slaty colour. Something in the roof. Let's get that done and see what happens. There's a great big hole in this roof as well. Put some dark colours in there in a while, and it's a little darker on the front of the house though, quite a bit. Comes right down. So it's a really sad old building. Old lean-to here as well. And on this face we can put something as well. I think a good deal darker there. Doors here. Remains and a big old door there. Another one here. And the this is much, much darker here. Oh, that bit of the wall there. Much darker. Some old rafters are just about hanging on. Great big hole there. I can pick up from the paper by putting a bit of a dry brush over there, and it's going to be a bit of colour in there, not a lot. Right. Let's push on. Still greens are not right. This also needs to be darker, I think. And put a little bit of umber. Little bit of burnt umber along with our neutral colours and make that a bit darker there on this, and this was darker here and here. If you put some colour in when it's wet, you get it diffuses. Some nice little colours. Let me try and get some of these shapes in. So I should get our walls in. Wash a bit of our wall. They've got to be kept lightish, I think, if they're to do the job for us. I think I have to lift out some places where I've gone over. Yes. Let's get some different greens. Give me some differences which I need. Give some form. It's coming right over here. coming over the store, it's invading the store. Big pile in, oh yes, I think that's where my big pile is. And also out here, I've got some more, which I think I'm going to lift out with a damp brush. There's a big pile of stones here, so I lifted that a little bit. And there's greens coming down our wall there. Let's lift a bit of those and get some hints of the stones. Along here was the bit of ash felt. Let's wipe that out so we can see a little bit where our sheep are going. The path is sweeping around here. Wonder if I could drop some Chinese white, fairly thick Chinese white, into my stones to help create. Oh yes, and on that, on the top of the wall there, as I say, we've got quite a pile here, which I think I'll deal with in a moment. We've also got some all out here, just remains of old stones, remains of a little wall there. And I think here we had a nice rock as well, just poking out. Another one's here. And it's a bit of white on our trackway. Collapse. Get me a little darker. Bring that down there. And there's a hole in that. Was extensive. Even breaking through there, this old window there, and out there some darks, far too dark in our stone pile. I smudge it a little bit, take the intensity away, and got some stones up here, try and give some
kind of shape to these old walls. We could put some greys in now. So blend in for our wall. In a moment, I'll go back with some dry brush there and put some shapes of the rocks when it's not quite so wet. Then on there, and on this far wall, I think this is again remains of the walls. They're long gone. Which edge this trackway. Over here, right. I think I need a bit of brighter green in some places, but let's put a bit of dark. That's just too dark. Let's add a bit of green under these trees. This sort of very coarse grass, which is a feature of this photograph. Yes. Wipe in something of the road still. Comes along. Yes, it's which I did sketch in, but I lost somewhat. Here he is, he's back again, as if by magic. A little darker on the hillside there, hiding away there. Let's get the let's put our tree in. We'll get the trunks in first. I think we had one there. Quite a nice one there. Came up like this. It's a little wet. Need to make that a bit darker and a little drier. So we have another one here. Another one slightly in the difference there. hue coming out like this. Until I'm ready with a different brush. As I said, we've got to try and get these walls, try and create some hint of the walls. And some of these dry grasses, I think. I think a different brush, something a little bit more. Some suggestion here using the side of my brush, slightly dry. Let's try and keep it fresh. A few dark strokes in as well, I think. Otherwise, it'll look a bit flat. So, get our green, bit of ultramarine, tone it down a little bit, put a little bit of umber in it. Blue out a little bit, and then I can, the bits that are not getting the light, so I can lower parts of the tree, lower parts of the limbs, I can perhaps get a little hint there in the heart of the tree. You don't see quite so much because this hidden a little bit from the light. So we'll just flick in a few bits we can. Let's leave it at that for the moment. Can always go back and put some more finer twigs in, perhaps some sort of branches. Need to darken up a little bit in the this lower portion. You don't see so clearly in a tree at the bottom. So let's leave it at that. The sheep. We've got to get them in. There's no denying. We've got to have a go in getting these Larry the Lamb in. I think we can do something with the grasses a bit later. I think I can improve on that. Yes, let's get some sheep. So I think I'm going to just have to have a go with some really good white paint and try and get some of the shapes. Because I mean, we're only looking at the rear end largely all these. I think I need to put some gouache out on my palette. Mix it up properly with the base material it has in it. You see here, got the fluid, the base that it uses to combine it. So, got a nice creamy white. So, okay, let's bite the bullet. Usually pretty round, rotund characters, aren't they? I put some legs on them. We've got some more here. Yeah. We'll put some legs and some colouring into them. We'll hopefully make them a little bit more shape-like. Some of these sheep have got horns as well. Let's flex in that roof as well. Bits of on the walls. The corner of this house, it's tumble turned. Right. Yeah, we've got another one up here. I need to deal with my my grasses more. I think I need to get that sorted out. Some dry brush and a nice sharp brush with a bit of spike to it. What about that? Clumps of grass. Some going, some browny yellows. Yes, that's and I also had some sort of yellows as well. Little clumps. Get some brighter greens in. Get a yellow. Get some yellow, which we can hopefully will blend with some of these. Yes, that's looks a bit. Give a bit of light into there. Of a warm colour and a little bit of sunshine coming through, and our grass is not as bright and green as I was hoping, but let's see what I can do to improve that. Yes. That's a little better. In the distance there was a bit of green there. And a little bit greener perhaps. In places, more vivid. Out there was quite a vivid bit of green there. And along this part of the path was a pretty vivid green as well. sense of it. Beef up that a bit along that margin. Some intensity in the foreground, usually a bit darker, more intense. Some tufts of grass perhaps there. Right, now could I do something with my sheep? Are they dry? Yes, let's have a go, see if we can suggest some form to these little fellas or ladies, whoever they are. Got some rear ends here, got some black heads there. To just suggest a bigger end here, head there. Maybe he's a black-headed one. Yes, perhaps an idea. They can be black face sheep. I'll suggest that a little. Different colours on this one. Bit of ochre. I think we need to put on some of these. They're a bit on the bright side. Oh. make a living, I think, in this part of Ireland. State of these, this land, very poor. Give us a bit more silhouette against the light that come down here. Some very fine piece of the tree. And I'm trying to look dark in there, another bit of the ruin there. And under this was dark, under this overhang of whole vegetation, quite dark. There's some very fine. No, that's too thick. I need some. Give us a lot more fine branches. If I take my time. Not holding the paint so well. Details. Yes, that's better. Some fine little marks. Give some little marks, suggest the branches out in the canopy here. I wonder if I could put any horns on any of these sheep with this tiny little brush. Maybe. Yes, I think we could. Except I don't want it black, do I? I don't think they have black horns, but we've got to have something to stand out. It will show a little bit. This one in the foreground, give him a bit more attention. Let's thicken up the paint a bit. And he's got it coming down like that. Yes, that's better. And this fellow too. Yep. Where else can I see a little bit of horn? Yes. Yeah, I think that'll do it. And as I say, we've got to try and flick some. Right. Well, I think I've probably done as much as I can do. At this point, right. things. Like some grass, tufts of grass, some texture. Right, now what I could I put any more detail in the house itself? Put a little bit under there, a few marks on this whole house. You can see the stonework, and in fact you can hear. So I think we'll give it a little bit of attention. Just a hint, you can't do them all, but you can suggest at them. This is what you need, so the viewer can make his own decisions. What is he looking at? My stone here. Put a few fissures in that. An R shape. Have I done enough for them? Some suggestions there. Oh, should I put a bit? I know, I could put a bit of marker on them. Some of them got orange. Must be the identification that the farmer uses. And I've got a couple here. I got another one. Where should I put it here? It. Well, they've all got a little bit of a marker on. So anyway, there we are, our very tumbled down old cottage in rural Ireland. I've tried to capture something of its dereliction with its roof falling apart here, and a rather loose interpretation of the sheep, and some attempt to get this grasses, this huge variety of grasses, which I can only attempt at a few marks to suggest it. There you are. I think I could put a few flicks there to suggest it. Right, on the side. Okay, well, there you go. Rural Ireland. Well, there is my finished article, my little concluding bit. I've tried to keep it nice and bright. Broody, of course, and rather sad, I think, but wonderful colours and full of history. So I've tried to capture that with varying degrees of success. My sheep are definitely very generic. James Herriot wouldn't be impressed with them, but I think they'll work from a distance. You're not going to do a detailed examination of them. And I've tried to keep the colours fairly fresh, not to overwork them, which is always the danger with the watercolour.